ever walked out of an exam and felt about this small? Whether it be the result of poor studying or a terrible professor, I think most of us have been there at least once or twice. These tips you're about to hear have been curtailed toward engineering majors, but feel free to tweak and mold them as you please. There are several obvious ways to improve exam scores: studying, reading textbooks, doing your homework, but we'll be taking a different approach in this video. This is how to pass an engineering exam. Tip 1. If you don't know it, assume it. Professors would much rather you pull a random arbitrary value out of thin air than proceed to solve the problem neglecting it altogether. Here's an example in fluid dynamics. Suppose your task is to calculate the power of a pump required to drive a liquid through 1600 feet of 8-inch pipe. If our friction factor is 0.005, average pipe velocity 10 feet per second, mass flow rate 10 slugs per second, and acceleration due to gravity 32.2 feet per second squared, then all we need to do is calculate head loss from this equation and multiply that product by the mass flow rate and acceleration due to gravity once more. This kind of math is 99% plug and chug, basic algebra. Now let's assume for sick kicks that you cannot remember the head loss equation. Great, there goes one vital piece of the puzzle. Well, instead of stopping here, panicking, and turning the page as tears roll down your face, do this. Write assume, in all caps I recommend, head loss equals, say, 100 feet. This assumption may have just saved your grade. Professors will look at this, probably realize that this magical number is a complete fabrication, mark off a few points for that, and continue on grading. Even if this value proves to be way off, chances are this is the only place you'll be penalized. Your final answer will of course be wrong, but only as a result of your royal mistake a few lines up. It's placing a band-aid over a geyser, but better than failing to write a solution, however wrong it may be. Now let's move on to tip 2. If you're artistic in any way, shape, or form, don't be afraid to draw pictures and or graphs when necessary. At this point, it all comes down to how well you can pass off BS as legit work. You can really get away with this one in your physics classes. Suppose your problem involves lifting a 10 kilogram box, let's draw a box here, straight up a certain distance, say 10 feet. But you have no idea where to go from here. Draw a friggin' picture. Start with the ground, throw in some grass, maybe a tree or two, make it look pretty. Now, we've gotta get this box, let's label it 10 kilograms, up here, 10 feet. Sketch an imaginary crane of sorts and a rope connecting it to the box. In comes the free body diagram. Even if you cannot remember the force and work equations needed to solve this problem, you'll more than likely squeak by with some partial credit just for this amazing work of art. It reminds professors that you aren't clueless and that you've genuinely tried. And hey, you sketched and labeled a free body diagram that wasn't even asked for. If a problem instead pertains to a graph or trend that you can recall, sketch that. Anything is better than nothing in an engineering exam. Tip 3. This will be hard for some of you, maintain an adequate level of maturity. Don't write smiley faces or obscure question marks on exams, these divulge your lack of know-how, and nothing will cheer up an engineering professor. Trust me, I've tried. Let's assume you're asked to name the chemical compound MgFe7Si8OH22, a magnesium iron silicate hydroxide. If you write coming tonight, followed by a smiley face or classic LOL, you deserve point deductions, plain and simple. By the way, this is the official name for this compound. Ladies, this isn't so much a problem for you as it is for us guys. Grow a beard and man up. Keep that maturity level on point, especially when in test-taking mode. Tip 4. Write neatly and in an organized manner. You will thank yourself later. I take this one very seriously. Check out my notes. And in purple. Such class. I choose to write in all caps because it allows me to better differentiate legit notes from longhand equations. If you combine tip 4 with tips 1 and 2, you'll be sitting good in the engineer neighborhood. It's a bit like PC cable management. It doesn't improve functionality in any way, but sure makes things easier to find and change later on. Here's the last resort option, tip 5. Act like you misunderstood the question. Let's assume the question asks for the total resistance in a circuit with 3 parallel 5 ohm resistors. If you can't remember the parallel summation notation, this right here, but you can remember the easy one, resistance in series, then pretend the question asks just that. What is the total resistance in a circuit with 3 series 5 ohm resistors? I suggest sticking with the word parallel though on paper and writing out the notation for series so as to fool your professor into thinking you simply mixed them up, which is much more forgivable than not remembering parallel notation altogether. Again, it's a last resort effort. Test taker's discretion is advised. But there's one last tip I cannot go without stating. That's tip 6. Be confident, even if you know without a shadow of a doubt that your answer is incorrect. Tips 1 through 5 will not work without confidence. Be confident in your assumptions, confident in your sketches, confident in your writing, and be confident in your confidence. It's like the old saying goes, you can go anywhere in the world you want if you appear confident and carry a clipboard. Don't bring a clipboard to an engineering exam, though. That will certainly draw unwarranted attention. Bad news if you plan on stuffing functions into your handy graphing calculator. Yeah, I know. I've been there. If you like this video, like the tips, be sure to give this one a thumbs up, thumbs down. If you feel the complete opposite, be sure to click the subscribe button if you haven't already. Stay tuned for an ultra budget-friendly micro ATX PC build. This is Salazar Studio. Thanks for learning with us.